Haley, why is the White House trashing Dr. Fauci and sending out opposition research like memos to reporters? The president has gone off on anonymous sources in the past. Why not have the guts to trash Dr. Fauci with your own names?
So, President Trump, I'll refer you back. There's no opposition research being dumped to reporters. We were asked a very specific question by the Washington Post, and that question was, President Trump noted that Dr. Fauci had made some mistakes, and we provided a direct answer to what was a direct question.
Hasn't the president made mistakes? He suggested at one point that Americans inject themselves with disinfectants, that sort of thing. Why not send out these notes to reporters about what Dr. Fauci said in the past with your names on it?
They
were sent out by a White House official. The president has said he doesn't trust anonymous sources, and yet you were sending out these notes to reporters anonymously.
Look, I would note that in terms of the president and his record on coronavirus, he stands by the actions and the steps he's taken in this historic response. You have Dr. Fauci, who said that the record of this president is impressive. I can't imagine that under any circumstance that anybody could be doing more. And those are the words of Dr. Fauci. We provided a direct response to a direct question, and that's about it. And to the notion that there's opposition research and that there's Fauci versus the president couldn't be further from the truth. Dr. Fauci and the president have always had a very good working relationship.
So let's go to the White House right now. Our chief White House correspondent, Jim Acosta, is joining us. Jim, the White House clearly doesn't like the science and the facts that Dr. Fauci is trying to get out to the American public amid this horrific pandemic.
Oh, that's right, Wolf. White House officials appear to be backing off after taking some jabs at Dr. Anthony Fauci over his comments about the coronavirus pandemic. The president and other officials are now saying on the record that Mr. Trump and Dr. Fauci have a good working relationship. That is notable given the fact that some aides to the president have been spending the last couple of days trashing Fauci anonymously to reporters.
After spending days railing against Dr. Anthony Fauci, President Trump and his top aides seem to be pulling back from what appear to be a campaign to undermine one of the nation's most trusted health experts.
I have a very good relationship with Dr. Fauci. I've had for a long time, right from the beginning. I find him to be a very nice person. I don't always agree with him. I get along with him very well. I like him.
Even though his access to the president is all but cut off and his TV appearances have been blocked by White House officials, it's Fauci who is still offering Americans a dose of reality, warning the coronavirus pandemic remains a danger to the public.
We haven't even begun to see the end of it yet, but until you get it completely under control, it's still going to be a threat.
Even as coronavirus cases reach record numbers in multiple states over the last few days, White House aides have blasted Fauci anonymously, telling reporters several White House officials are concerned about the number of times Dr. Fauci has been wrong on things.
Why not have the guts to trash Dr. Fauci with your own names?
So, President Trump, I'll refer you back. There's no opposition research being dumped to reporters. To the notion that there's opposition research and that there's Fauci versus the president couldn't be further from the truth. Dr. Fauci and the president have always had a very good working relationship.
While sometimes questioning the expertise of Fauci, who was once awarded the Presidential Medal of Freedom, Mr. Trump appears to be putting his faith in people who aren't scientists, retweeting this tweet from former game show host Chuck Woolery, who claims the most outrageous lies are the ones about COVID-19. Everyone is lying. The CDC, media, Democrats, our doctors, not all but most, that we are told to trust. Even though he's just recently embraced wearing a mask and is still downplaying the threat posed by the virus.
We're at about 135,000 and we'll be at somewhat higher than that by the time it ends.
Mr. Trump is offering up a new conspiracy that unnamed forces are working in cahoots to keep schools closed to damage his reelection chances.
We have to open the schools. We have to get them open. And I think there's a lot of politics going along. I think they think they'll do better if they can keep the schools closed in the election. I don't think it's going to help them, frankly, but I think they feel that by keeping schools closed, that's a bad thing for the country, and therefore that's a good thing for them.
That came a day after Education Secretary Betsy DeVos falsely claimed there is no health risk in sending children back to school, when it's likely some students will pass the virus on to teachers.
There is nothing in the data that would suggest that kids being back in school is dangerous to them. And in fact, it's more a matter of their health and well-being that they be back in school.
Former White House Chief of Staff Mick Mulvaney is acknowledging there have been problems with the administration's response, writing in an op-ed on CNBC's website, "I know it isn't popular to talk about in some Republican circles, but we still have a testing problem in this country." As for his decision to commute the sentence of former Trump campaign advisor Roger Stone, the president is standing by the controversial move that was opposed by some top officials in his own administration.
"I'm getting rave reviews for what I did for Roger Stone."
Attorney General William Barr, who said he approved of the Stone prosecution, is now praising the president.
"First, let me say what an honor it is for me to serve under a president who is such a strong supporter of law enforcement."
Now, as for Fauci, the last time he spoke with the president was on June 2nd, more than a month ago. White House officials concede it would be difficult to fire Fauci, and I'm told Fauci believes the best thing he can do at this point is to continue to tell the truth about the virus to the American people, and that he has accepted the fact that he cannot do much to stem this criticism coming from the White House. Fauci has served presidents from both parties over the years. Besides his experience in infectious diseases, he also appears to understand how to survive in Washington.
Yeah, Wolf. He served six American presidents, as you point out, Democrats and Republicans. Jim Acosta at the White House, thank you very much. Let's get some more on all of this. Dr. Boris Lushniak is joining us. He's the former acting Surgeon General of the United States. He's the Dean of the University of Maryland School of Public Health. Thanks so much, Dr. Lushniak, for joining us. The California governor, you just heard, Gavin Newsom, he just shut down all indoor activities throughout the entire state. Do you think that was a necessary step to contain this outbreak?
Without a doubt, it was necessary, Wolf. You know, we have to really realize that we have to react to what the information is telling us. And actually, I'm going to tell you that this is actually on the whitehouse.gov site under Opening Up America Again, where it talks about the plans and talks about, and I'll quote here directly, "monitor conditions and immediately take steps to limit and mitigate any rebounds or outbreaks by restarting a phase or returning to an earlier phase, depending on the severity." And Governor Newsom is taking the right step, which is there's a problem in California right now, so let's back off a little bit. Unpopular, but critical for the public's health.
Is it something you think that other governors in various hotspots, and there are plenty of them around the country, need to consider at this point?
Yes. I mean, they have to react to the reality of the situation in their own jurisdictions. And so when you talk about the number of states right now that are increasing in terms of number of cases and soon undoubtedly number of deaths, ICUs, hospitals being overrun with patients who have COVID-19, that proves that the disease is rampant in the community. The only way you can stop this is by backing off and making sure that community takes care of itself.
As you know, Florida just set the highest single-day case count for any state since the beginning of the pandemic back in January and February. Would a similar order in Florida even be enough to contain the surge in that state right now?
Well, it's going to be a combination of things. You know, you go back to the idea what Tony Fauci had said earlier on this broadcast, and the idea is we go back to the basics, right? And we've been talking about this since day one with modifications as we learn more about this. But the whole idea is put on the masks, wash your hands, stay away from others, and ultimately the large group gatherings is really what's causing a major problem. So Florida, it would be important for Florida to look at the information that's coming in and to back off.
Dr. Fauci says that we don't necessarily need to shut down entirely the entire country. Just pull back a bit, he says. Do you think pulling back a bit is going to be enough to contain the current surge?
I think there's several things. Yes, pulling it back a bit in the hot areas are going to be very important for us to achieve our goals. Overall, though, as a nation, we have to look at the idea that it's in our communities. If it's in our communities, our obligation as people are to protect others from ourselves. So the whole idea of wearing the mask is still going to be critical, and the whole idea of being wise with large group gatherings. I think this is part of a formula, right? I'm an optimist in all this, part of a formula that we are going to be successful at. But getting there is much too painful right now. We could have done this months ago.
I want to get your reaction to the effort inside the White House right now to discredit Dr. Fauci. And you know him. I'm sure you worked with him when you were the acting Surgeon General of the United States under President Obama. Would you ever have imagined the administration launching a campaign to try to undermine their own top infectious disease expert right in the middle of a pandemic?
You know, I used the terms last week on another thing that came from the White House. I'm going to use two terms here, ridiculous and dangerous. This is absolutely horrendous that this is going on at this critical point of a pandemic. What we have to do is speak with one voice, telling people this is real and telling them how we can prevent the spread of this further in our society. And to spend all this effort of finger pointing, to spend all this effort of undermining someone with the reputation of Dr. Fauci is absolutely ridiculous and dangerous.
Dr. Lushniak, thanks so much for joining us.